Greetings and hallucinations, ladies and lads. I am Chancellor of the Harmonious Frequencies of the Mighty Empire of Onion, and this is Astroneer. So a new update has been released. It's supposed to improve the way that research is done. It adds augments to your little terrain tool here. You can see I can now select it, and I'm going to be able to add things to the sides. Different things. There's an analyzer to analyze terrain. You can change the color of terrains, I believe. I know for sure that you will be able to change the size of the terrain tool cursor. It'll also tell you what color the terrain is. I can see already it used to be green. Now it's the blue circle with the white there. And then it's red over here, and if I'm seeing it correctly, I feel like that white arrow is going to change color with whatever color the terrain is, because you could see the terrain of the moon is kind of a gray, and then it turns to no color on stuff that I can't dig. Still white there, but yeah. So I thought, well, before I start recording, I'm going to run out into this cave, grab a bunch of compound, craft up some filters, run down into the hole and find my truck. And apparently, whenever they changed the research, they changed what I have researched. When I first opened up my backpack, I had power cells selected, and so it was available for me to craft, but I immediately changed it away from that to look for filters. And lo and behold, I don't have anything researched. So I came back up here to check this out. I don't have a truck. I don't have any sort of spacecraft available to me. Excuse me. Plugged in my phone because it's dead. This is what happens when it comes back to life. And then I hadn't checked the printer though, but apparently the only thing I can print now is a seat. You saw with your own eyes that it had the wind turbine available there at first, and now all it is a seat. So, what I propose to do in this episode is to return to the Terran planet. I had already kind of thought about that. I was being super optimistic considering going to collect my truck and trailer that are trapped in the center of the planet. I was going to bring them back here and then go looking for research around the moon, because I think that would be pretty easy to find. But I think it's going to be even easier on the Terran planet. They said that they made research chests, or what they call them. They made them more rare to find. And so that's actually good, because they used to be laying everywhere. But yeah, so that's my plan, is to go back to the Terran planet and round up a load of research with the truck and trailer that I have available that I know isn't going to go flying around everywhere, and see what new goodness we can come up with. They said it makes it more difficult to increase your technology in the beginning of the game, so I'm assuming that it means sometimes you'll get research, sometimes you'll get resources, whether or not you've researched a certain chest type. And so we know in the past we've already researched a bunch of these, but here we go with new stuff because it's all been reset. So we have the shuttle now. That's the basic, yeah, the small spacecraft. It may be by mouse, but I'm having a little bit of inconsistencies with the camera controls. So here we go. We researched one of these just now, so I'm going to research another one immediately and see what differences we're able to discover. If we come up with, yeah, just a resource, that's what I expected to happen. But that's what happened in the past as well. So I'm curious to know, are there going to be different kinds of researches on different planets? Or are the regular researchers still going to be available on the old planets and all that kind of stuff? There's one more red research that I would like to snatch from here. There's a green one too that may be available to grab. I noticed this before. My screen is turning red around the edges. Just because I was sort of venturing towards that area over there. The closer I get to my base, it disappears. I'm not sure what that's about. I wasn't suffocating or anything, so. Let's see if we just get a straight resource out of this guy, though. Which I assume will be the case, yeah. Another compound. Okay, let's grab that green one real quick and see what we can do with him. Oh, and I'd like to see... Yeah, okay, that arrow has changed to pink over this pink terrain, and then it changes to that gray-brown color over the gray-brown terrain. So that is a new feature. Oh, oh, pretty sure it's under here. Please don't fall. There we go. Okay, so this is the same kind of research, clearly, the spiky plant sort of guy. But since it's a different color, I'm gonna cross my fingers and hope that this yields a new sort of research. And when I first started up, I was annoyed that the research was all reset because I did suffocate in the cave. I had to go back and grab my stuff, but that's a part of alpha games. There's no real reason for me to be annoyed about this kind of stuff because they're trying to improve the game. They're trying to bring out new content and better updates and stuff like that. So I'm really grateful for the development team staying with it, trying to do their best to make improvements and make the game more enjoyable for lots of people. Let's go check those rocks over there for rock type research chests. Gotta remember I'm on the moon and the gravity is very unforgiving. Okay, yeah. All of these used to have researches on them. So as we can clearly see, that's not the case anymore. I wonder if there's gonna be researches underneath them. I don't want to destroy the formations. That keeps confusing me, that my spaceship under there. I don't want to destroy the formations like that guy just popped out of the ground. That guy as well. But I really wanted to check for researches underneath. The rock types were mostly above ground. It looks like I'm harvesting the earth now. The terrain, I should say. See how it flies towards my tool and kind of gets sucked into it? Yeah, there's definitely no research underneath there. So that's going to be a little more difficult to find. Those were the easiest researches to grab a hold of right there. So I believe I'm going to abandon the moon base for now and head back to the Terran planet. We'll go research hunting down there. Can I not enter my spaceship? Okay, I didn't see the tab thing showing up, but we are able to get in here, even though we don't have this researched anymore. Oh, it's so weird. Let's zoom out here and get a good view. Before I knew that this update had released, I was considering just visiting the other planets and then ending the series, but I am pretty interested in finding out what this new update has for us. The Tundra planet looks like it's gotten the worst of the update here. It's clearly been blown into four pieces. The Death Star has swung by our solar system to test its weapons. Thankfully, we were hiding on the moon, so they didn't scan the moon, only the planets, for life forms. We luckily escaped its devastating blast. But the Tundra planet had no such luck. Anyway. So I think that's our moon base. It's hard to tell. That sort of weird, buggy planetary disembodied bases sort of thing has happened since the game first came out, so that's nothing new. I don't know which bubble to land in that's going to be our proper space base. Vehicle bay that I built. We'll try the upper one and see what our luck is like. Oh yeah, perfect. Right on top of the truck. Okay, so let's hop out of here. Yeah, that's not something that I'm probably going to remember. Let's see if we can get disconnected, though. Some of the bug fixes said that they worked on the vehicles, too. And I don't know what that means, but... yeah, hopefully they react a little bit better to terrain and stuff like that. That's my hopes, anyways. Alright, so let's hop out here. This should clearly be vanished. Yeah, those rocks shouldn't exist there, but there's apparently nothing I can do about it. We have a bunch of compound on our backs. Wow. I don't remember this stuff being so close, but I suppose it likely was. It looks like there's still research on every tree. So that sort of research provision hasn't declined at all. And we've got beacons out here. I think that those mark research that we didn't pick up, but I can't be sure. One of them could be like a compound node, one of the renewable sorts. Right. Let's get our research on. Yeah. New stuff here. The truck. Excellent. So I can see some of those bubbly looking plants over there. There's these green blocky sort of plant researches. Oh, come on. If it has the blue ring around it, I should be able to... Oh, I'm holding shift, that's why. I'm trying to grab it fast. I can't tell if that one over there is green or blue. It looks blue to me. But I could be mistaken. It wouldn't be the first time in my life. After I bring this one back, we'll use the truck. I'll gather up a number of different researches at one time. Alright, all of these are yielding new things, of course, because we have no technology right now. Storage. I don't know if that's going to be vehicle storage or the storage pods for the printer. It looks like it's for the printer because that's not changing at all. Yeah, it's not changing on the truck. That could be because there's no room, but I feel like it meant printer storage. Okay, so let's take a buzz around. Let's go over this mountain range. That's clearly the best plan. Let's take a peek inside. I don't think there's anything in there that we need. I already mentioned that those beacons are probably marking some research, so maybe I should head that direction. I feel like there's a bridge over this? No, it's just not a real cavern, it's a slight cave. I also heard with this update that hydrazine is no longer accepted in the trade platform. I imagine that's because of the exploit of the fuel condenser basically being infinite resources for everything. You could just make hydrogen out of basically thin air, or in this case, you know, energy, and then trade it for whatever you needed. Yeah, this is a resin resource here. God, doesn't look like anything much over in that direction. Here's a rock formation, but I don't see any sort of rock research nodes here. Chests, I should call them, because that's what the developers call them. Let's look around. This looks like it's been looted. So I imagine that's still the case on the inside. And I don't see anything back there, so we might head this way. Yeah, it looks like the trailer is staying upright through some pretty strenuous driving practices. Yep, it took on that hill pretty easily. Yeah. Trying to use my brain here, but I should have attached the solar onto here before I even got started. Now the sun's almost down and I'm almost out of power. Maybe we'll find some laying around though. There's a node right there as I speak. And these things always catch my eye because I feel like that little piece could attach to something. It looks like the nodes that attach to the front and back of trucks. Yeah, this has been looted for sure. I'll bet money that one has as well. There's another power node over there though, so I could make my way over that direction and snatch up a few of those. It looks like we're gathering up some purple terrain as well as we go here. And it also looks like the wind has picked up quite a bit. So if I had brought my little wind generator, I could have put that to good use. I'm thinking I have a big one back at the base as well. Yeah, this has been looted and there's no research around it. Now I was sure at one place or another I discovered a great many rock type research chests, I should say, during my circumnavigation quest. But I definitely do want to pick up some spaceship style researches. This one looks like there's still some. There's a square one here for sure. Yeah, definitely having a difficult time engaging the camera controls. Oh, there's even something inside the ship here. Yeah, I must have just overlooked that one. Is that attaching to the crane? Feels like it is. So there's our first new spaceship research. Got another power node. I think we'll be good until morning. There's a rock there. I should check it for rock type researches. There's also that spiky plant in the distance over here. I feel like we'll have a research underneath it. Yeah, I'm not seeing a rock type research on there. Oh, there's one on a tree, actually. Okay. I will accept your gift, tree. Your contribution to my intelligence and ability to craft fantastic things. I wonder if there's going to be anything up here. Let's go check out these rock formations. Several cool rock formations here. We've got these mushroom-looking things. Those pillars down there, obelisks. And that looks like basalt. Not bath salts, but basalt, the lava formation. There's something crazy over there, some kind of bright orange. I don't want to drive the truck through here. I feel like that's a given. I feel like I've seen that movie before somewhere. Whoa. Yeah, the camera controls are definitely bugging out on me a little bit. Because even when I've already engaged right-click and I'm trying to run and look at the same time, weird things happen. I want to try to collect it without tearing down the tree. We'll see how feasible of an option that is. Come on. Oh, I totally had it there. Alright. Okay. We're down to, 25% oxygen, but there's a... Come on now. A load of oxygen over here. Come on, gather it up. Okay. It's barely giving us 25%, so let's grab up the rest of it. Because we just have to make it back to the base, or I mean the truck. I don't see anything immediately of interest down in there. Yeah, we can't even craft filters from all this compound I have on my back. I probably should have just left that at the base, because I'm not going to have any need for it. Wow, already? Let's see. Yeah, sprint doesn't seem to be very effective when I'm suffocating. Please make it. Excellent. Ooh. Pretty sure I was almost dead right there. No, he's just not sprinting. He's changed his mind about being able to run for some reason. No. There we go. There's some oxygen down there. Take a look. Just inside the cave. Okay, we've got spitter plants up here, which are most likely going to have the red. Yeah, red research as per usual. The sticky plant. There's a green one. Put there down. There ought to be... I thought that one was alive for a minute. There ought to be some sort of research attached to this thing. Oh, hello. But I'm sure we'll encounter another one of those plants elsewhere. And I figure it'll probably still be a plant-based research. I don't see anything interesting back there. That's a very cool cave up into that mountain, but I don't think we're gonna follow it. Yeah, let's get a little bit of air, and then I'll check underneath this thing. No. I think they used to have research underneath them, but clearly that one doesn't. Okay, it looks like he's running now, so I don't know why he decided not to there for a short while. I've actually lost track of where the base is. I think it's in that direction. But this caught my eye over here. Got this. Ooh, stuck underneath. Come on now. There we go. Just gotta wiggle around the right way. Okay, this one for sure I'm gonna take. Even though it's a different color, should I take this one? I'm not certain that I should. Yeah, it's not even letting me grab it, so I'm gonna take that as a sign that we should check out something different. Yeah, it looks like there isn't a research on every single tree like there used to be. It looked like that was the case back at the base, but I can see now it's incorrect. A lot of these trees are without research. That one's got a blue one, but we have an orange one. I don't know if those are going to be different. There's one down in the hole here. This is definitely different. Alright. We're really, really collecting the good stuff now. Oh, I didn't even notice that one up on that tree. That could just be a regular square one, like the yellow piece that we've already collected. But it looks really cool, though. I think we're gonna bring that one back. There's a pink one like the one we just grabbed. Oh, is it not gonna let me? There we go. Oh, wow. That was a little bit further of a drop than I should have taken so lightly. Oh, we have a generator attached to this side. I didn't even realize. Let's move it over to here. That'll be our power generation station. Let's see. So we have different kinds. We have several different kinds now. I feel like those green bubblies we've already researched. Like this here. And this red. Yeah, that's just the green and red sort that we've already researched as well. Yeah, there's that beacon that was the resin. So let's head back towards that, make sort of a big circle here. Ah, there's some rock formations with research on top of them. Let's see if they're different kinds from what we've already collected. I can already see a box rock type there. That one's probably a pyramid-shaped rock type. So those two might be pieces that we've already gotten. Oh no, that's the strange green shape. Whoa. I don't think we want to fall into this cavern. Though it's not too bad. It looks pretty thin over here. Not sure why, but I just tried to press F to get out of the truck. This one for sure is different. And this one is the same. This one is not the same as the yellow. So it's coming along with us. Stick this in the front because it seems to be aerodynamic. And then I feel like this one over here is also different. So let's see if we can drive through and get to the other side. I'll grab that one up. Yeah, there's the base in the distance. So I totally agree with this update. The research was way too easy to find at the beginning. And there was way too much of the same stuff just floating around right next to bases and stuff. It wasn't really worth running around to look for. Are these similar? They're similar, they're not the same. Okay. So those rock formations provided the most kinds of research for us this time, where in the past it was mostly the trees and underground plants. I'm sure there's still going to be more kinds. I know for a fact that there are different spaceship parts that we haven't collected up yet. I may have to do another circumnavigation effort in a different direction, though. Instead of east and west, I'll have to go like north and south. Man, I'd already forgotten about this planet. The cool formations and stuff, this huge cavern. I think this is a tiny bridge that I built. It is. A little tiny bridge. Allow me to pass over. Oh, that front piece research is hindering my advancements. There we go. Oh yeah, the back research piece has fallen off, and we've dislodged the front one successfully. Okay, front one, you're gonna be done first. Get so researched. See what new madness we are capable of. Fuel condenser, excellent. It's a good thing we already have one of those. Okay, the battery. So this is all working pretty much exactly the way that it used to, it feels like to me. About the same level of technology going first. Filters, finally. Good. So we can go far away from oxygen sources without dying so easily. Power cells, excellent. Okay, the spaceship piece here. Ooh, we do have quite a lot to research, so this is good. Inhibitor. So that's a new thing that we haven't checked out before. I believe that that's a tool for the terrain tool. I think... Don't quote me on this, because I might be lying. Here we go. Copper needed for this. I think that this is going to decrease the size and increase the intensity of my tool here. So if I build the inhibitor, is it going to fall on the ground? That's my first question. No, it flew away onto the ground. Okay, does this, it does attach to the thing. Augment. Okay. So now... Oh, no. I was wrong. It doesn't decrease the size, it lowers the intensity. And so now we're not digging nearly as quickly as we were before. Not even close. Oh wow, that's a cool effect. Those things kind of wave around in the wind and stuff. And hide behind the truck for a little while. See if we could get one more started before the boxes of death come. Trade platform. So that's one we already had. Oh, death boxes. Doesn't put the parking brake on when I'm inside. Battery? I feel like we already researched that. Oh, but there's a battery for the backpack and there's a battery for the printer. So that's what that was all about. The death boxes don't seem to be quite so numerous as they used to. And they don't even seem to be impacting anything. They definitely don't play the same sound effects, and they seem to be stopping, disappearing right where I'm at. That's kind of interesting. Okay. Two more? Or, yeah. Yeah, two more. Man, truck empties out quick. Maybe I should leave the winch here next time and grab one extra. Researched oxygen? Not even sure I know what that means. Okay, now. Got all of those. Let's see, we've got one seat here, storage, battery, and seat. So what does it mean? What does it mean that we researched oxygen? Got a rover, and a truck, and a shuttle. We've got the one seat attachment, and that's all. Huh. So I can't... Huh. I wonder what it means that we researched oxygen. Wind vane, okay. Let's see if that's the little one. Yeah. So that's good. I like that pretty well. Alright. Well, yeah, we figured out that the inhibitor decreases the speed at which we can dig. So we could do more exact sorts of things. I feel like this is going to place great terrain. It does. If I try to add, it's going to add gray terrain. How do I change that? Because I know that we've picked up purple terrain. I feel like I should be able to spin this around, but I can't do that with the backpack either. And when I hit Alt, I can see there's gray terrain like this, so I could slowly add more gray terrain. If I dig down, it absorbs the gray terrain. Very slowly. That inhibitor works like a dream. Let's take it off. Now that we've seen what it does, I want to, want to get rid of it for right now. Yeah, that's a huge difference. But yeah, we can see there's the gray terrain. If I add terrain here, and of course the icon has changed. It's now an arrow up instead of the four arrows on the outside of the circle. And then level terrain is just the square. And it's got that, I've tried, this is what scroll wheel does, it just zooms in and out. Right click? No? Q? No. Q and E are for those things. Shift doesn't do anything. No. Let's see if there's controls in here. So we've got extend, build. Yep. Flatten, add, terrain, dig. Place, take. Nope. No updates on controls there to tell me how to change the color. Because we clearly have purple terrain in our tool, but it immediately goes to gray terrain when I try to flatten or raise. And I feel like even if I'm over here and I try to flatten the terrain this direction, yeah, it's adding gray terrain to flatten it rather than adding the purple, or even just flattening the terrain with purple. So that's curious. That's something that I'm going to have to play around with and discover the answer to. But yeah, very interesting. Very good update. I'm not going to lie, I'm actually kind of excited about doing more exploration, finding more researches, and bringing them back to the base to upgrade my ability to craft things. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. Hope you look forward to the next one. If you do, feel free to subscribe. Consider supporting if you would. And be sure to check out any of my other videos or playlists that you might be interested in. Thank you very much for any time that you spend on my channel. And I hope blessings of wisdom and peace on all of you. Farewell.